sands producer Syncrude has just been ordered to pay a $2.75 million fine to settle a series of charges levied against the company for bird deaths. But is this fair? Today I'll look at how other energy projects are treated when birds die. In 2015, 31 blue herons were found either dead or dying at a tailings pond at the Mildred Lake mine north of Fort McMurray. Now, Syncrude was charged with failing to properly store a hazardous substance under Alberta law and also faced federal charges under the Migratory Birds Act. And after over 3 years of litigation, Syncrude has agreed to pay a fine of nearly $89,000 per bird. Birds are expensive when they're killed by energy projects. Well, not really all energy projects, just like some energy projects, namely oil and gas ones. Let's take a look at wind turbines. And today I'm just going to take a look at Alberta wind turbines. I found this article here in the Calgary Herald from a few years ago. It has a very interesting statistic in it from the Alberta government. It reads, "The government estimates that each existing wind turbine in Alberta causes the deaths of 2 to 3 birds and 3 to 7 bats annually, putting the current totals at between 1,800 and 2,700 birds and between 2,700 and 6,300 bats provincially, or up to 9,000 fatalities in total. 9,000 bird and bat deaths caused every single year by wind turbines, and you don't hear about it because wind turbines are exempted from the same federal migratory bird laws that oil companies have to comply with. But I suspect the number is a lot higher than what Rachel Notley's NDP government is willing to admit to the public. You see, I found other numbers in a document called Wind Energy Bird and Bat Monitoring Database, Summary of the Findings from Post-Construction Monitoring Reports. The study is authored using data by Bird Studies Canada, the Canadian Wind Energy Association, Environment Canada, and the Ontario Ministry of Natural Resources, and is dated July 2016. So these are the wind energy's own numbers here. And I'm going to look, like I said, just at Alberta. Let's look at birds first. The total number of installed turbines in Alberta as of December 2015 was 958, resulting in an estimate of 2,538 non-raptor bird fatalities, but the number could be as high as 3,258, and then 60 raptor fatalities, but that number could be as high as 117 in this region between May 1st and October 31st, based on December 2015 installed capacity. So back in 2015, before the NDP saw a rush to build wind turbines, the government was aware that bird fatalities could be as high as 3,200 per year with another possible 117 raptor fatalities. Well, that's a lot higher than the 2,700 the Alberta government was talking about in 2017. And I can't imagine that they round the numbers down for Syncrude with bird fatalities. Now let's talk about bats. The total number of installed wind turbines, again, as of December 2015 was 958, resulting in an estimate of nearly 8,000 bat fatalities, but the number could be as high as 10,344 in our region between May 1st and October 31st, based on December 2015 capacity. So bat fatalities could be as high as 10,500. And let's be clear, this isn't even for a full year. This is from May 1st to October 31st. But even if no single bird or bat was killed by these bird blenders outside of the May 1st to October 31st, 2015 timeframe, if we only take the middle of the road numbers to be fair, we can estimate a total of 10,600 bird and bat deaths for just those 7 months. That means the wind energy industry, if the same rules were applied to them as they are to Syncrude, they would owe a fine of $940 million. And again, I want to stress that's just for part of the year in 2015. And these are just Alberta numbers. Wouldn't it be great if the slap chop blades of renewable energy were subjected to the same sort of fines as every other energy project when birds meet an untimely death? Actually, folks, hold that thought. The public cannot afford the expensive green energy subsidies to help wind companies pay those enormous fines. For the Rebel.media, I'm Sheila Gunn Reid. Conservatives and conservative media are both routinely censored or shadow banned by big tech companies, but we have our own way around that. If we ever get banned from social media, we have our own Rebel Media mobile app. Download it in the App Store or the Google Play Store. Give it a whirl and take the other side of the story with you wherever you go.